Hello my dear friends, welcome back to the channel, and this is your friend Dr. Suresh Shenvi. Thank you so much for liking my earlier video on zinc phosphate, and today we are covering the zinc polycarboxylate. Zinc polycarboxylate is very important for various exams, and the obvious question is why when we don't use it so much in our practice. That is because of one important property, and that property is often asked in the exam, that it was the first cement to chemically bond with the two structure, and the other cement which can bond chemically with the two structure is glass ionomer cement, and that's often asked in your exam. The major component of powder here too is zinc oxide. Along with that, they have added magnesium oxide, but the textbooks also mention that the magnesium oxide can be replaced partially with stannic oxide. And we also have the same bismuth trioxide which is present in the zinc phosphate cement too. So what is the major component which differentiates the powder of zinc polycarboxylate from zinc phosphate? That is the presence of stannous fluoride, which has two functions. That is, it increases the strength and it also modifies the manipulative and working properties of the cement. Keep watching this video and you will know why this component is also important for another major function, and that function is very routinely asked in your exam. Now let's talk about the liquid component, and this is the major differentiating feature between the zinc phosphate cement and zinc polycarboxylate cement. The liquid here has polyacrylic acid instead of phosphoric acid, and it needed some modification because the liquid tends to gel over a period of time. So this was modified by adding itaconic and tartaric acid. Along with this, the second component is also water, which is very important for the setting reaction. There is a special form of the cement that is called as water settable or freeze-dried, in which the polyacrylic acid is freeze-dried and made like powder, and that is incorporated into a single bottle system which has that zinc oxide component and the polyacrylic acid powder. So when you get this in your clinic, you simply have to add water and you get the same basic original composition of the zinc phosphate powder liquid formulation. Is there any specific classification of the zinc polycarboxylate cement? There is no classification as such. And so let's talk about the setting reaction. Setting reaction here too is based on the same acid-base reaction what you see in the zinc phosphate, and the powder is the alkaline component and the liquid is polyacrylic acid, so it is the acidic component. To make the setting reaction simple, let us first look at the structure of the polyacrylic acid. It is basically made up of polymer of various groups of acrylic acid. But the point to be noted here is the yellow arrow in this picture, indicating that there is a special group which is very important for the setting reaction. And that special group is called as carboxylic group. Once you have understood this, we basically know that the powder is also made up of zinc oxide, magnesium and tin. So what happens is, when you mix the powder with the liquid, the acrylic acid will attack the powder particles and try to dissolve it. So when this happens, so the zinc, magnesium and tin ions will get released into the matrix, but these ions will then bind to this free carboxylic group. So the final structure is basically the various combination between the ions and the unreacted powder and the acrylic acid. At this point, look at the picture once again and you will realize that not all carboxylic groups are involved in the reaction, and you still have some amount of free carboxylic groups which are remaining. Keep watching this video and we'll know what is the importance of these free carboxylic group into the properties of the cement. So let's talk about the properties of the zinc polycarboxylate cement, and we'll try to compare it with the zinc phosphate. The first property being the flow or the viscosity. It is obvious that the viscosity of zinc polycarboxylate cement is more than the zinc phosphate cement. Hence, you may not get the 25 micron film thickness, which is generally ideal for a luting cement. But surprisingly, even after being more viscous, the zinc polycarboxylate has an ability to give a very thin film thickness of 25 micrometer. And that's because the polycarboxylate is considered to be pseudoplastic. Now, what does the pseudoplastic mean? It basically means that if you apply more pressure, the viscosity of the polycarboxylate cement will reduce. Although film thickness is less in zinc phosphate, but zinc phosphate has less film thickness, not because it has pseudoplastic, it is because zinc phosphate is Newtonian fluid. So let's compare the strength between zinc polycarboxylate and zinc phosphate, and there are some major differences. The compressive strength is really less, that is almost half with compared to the zinc phosphate, but the tensile strength is more. And the major difference is also there in elastic modulus, which is drastically reduced, making the cement less brittle. And if a cement is less brittle, then removal of excess of the cement from the margin once the cement sets becomes difficult. So let's talk about the major property of the zinc polycarboxylate, and that is how it retains into the cavity preparation, that is the bonding of the cement to the two structure. We know that the zinc phosphate bonds mechanically, but zinc polycarboxylate bonds chemically with the two structure. And if you remember that in setting reaction, I told you that we still have some amount of free carboxylic group. This free carboxylic group will bond with the calcium of the tooth and will give you a chemical bond with the two structure. And this is a very common question in your exam, and please remember it. Since the bonding depends on the amount of calcium in the tooth, obviously the bond strength will be better with the enamel because it has more inorganic component, and the bond strength will be slightly less with the dentin. Please remember that if you have smear layer on the tooth surface, which generally forms after cavity preparation, then the bond strength will not be attained completely. In order to improve it, you can always do something called as conditioning, where you apply 10% of polyacrylic acid for 10 to 15 seconds, and that removes the smear layer, giving a direct exposure of the tooth surface so that you can have better bond strength with the zinc polycarboxylate cement. Effect of the type of bonding is also seen the way the cement will fail. If you see the bond failure of zinc phosphate cement, then the failure generally occurs between the cement and the tooth interface, and that is because it's a mechanical bond. Whereas in the zinc polycarboxylate, you will see the failure into the cement and crown interface rather than cement and tooth interface, because there you have the chemical bond. If clinically you want to know whether you can attain the chemical bond with the tooth structure, that can be done by following a test called as loss of gloss test. This says that you should always have some amount of gloss into the cement mix, indicating directly that there is sufficient amount of free carboxylic group to attain chemical bond with the tooth structure. Now let's talk about the last major property of the zinc polycarboxylate cement. The major reason for replacing phosphoric acid with polyacrylic acid was to improve the pulp response to the cement. As we have learned in our last video that zinc phosphate is highly acidic since its initial pH is 2.14. However, in zinc polycarboxylate, the initial pH is 3.42. But that pH difference is not great. Then the question arises that why zinc polycarboxylate is better for pulp when compared to zinc phosphate? And there are two reasons. First reason is the molecular weight. The molecular weight of polyacrylic acid is 25 to 50,000, whereas the phosphoric acid is 10,000. The bigger the molecular weight of the liquid, the lesser the chance of entering into the dentinal tubule. So this basically prevents the liquid from entering the dentinal tubule and irritating the pulp, which doesn't happen with the zinc phosphate cement. And the second reason is how much powder you can add into the liquid in initial phases, which will definitely increase the pH, making it less acidic. In zinc phosphate, we cannot add a lot of powder in initial phases because it is an exothermic reaction and it affects the viscosity of the cement. However, in the zinc polycarboxylate, in initial phases, you can incorporate a lot of powder, hence increasing the pH drastically even in the initial phases. So that's why you can give zinc polycarboxylate as a base even if the remaining dentinal thickness is less than 1.5 millimeters. What about the anti-karyogenic property of the zinc polycarboxylate cement? In the composition, we learned that this cement powder has stannous fluoride, which is not present in the zinc phosphate cement powder. And this fluoride definitely gets released over a period of time from the restoration. Unfortunately, it is only 15 to 20% when compared to the other cements which have better anti-kerogenic property. So it's the quiz time, and it is an important question for the exam too. Can you name all the cements which have the fluoride releasing property, making them anti-kerogenic? Please write the answer into the comment section. Coming to the last section, that is manipulation, and I will highlight you the important things here. First point is that you don't have to use a large surface area because the reaction is not greatly exothermic. Second, the viscosity will greatly reduce if you mix faster and apply pressure to the cement. Third point is the powder liquid ratio, that is 1.5 powder to 1 part of liquid. And the last point to remember is that when the cement is in the rubbery stage while setting, do not pull the cement from the margins because it may create gap into the crown and the tooth structure. If you like this video, do subscribe to the channel and hit the like button and click the bell icon. I will see you once again very soon with another video on dental cements.